2021. Are you ready?
We're almost ready. In a few moments, all the 10 finalists will be here. Not all together, but one by one because of our safety measures. And of course, you have the opportunity to ask some questions. Only 3 questions. One question from someone from the qualified country, and one question from the international press. And of course, a question from someone who's watching in our online press area. And if you have any questions, please let us know.
And of course, after those questions, it's time for the allocation draw to find out in which half of the final the artists will have to perform this Saturday.
And when the draw has finished, there's an opportunity for Pool A photographers to take a photo at the photo wall. So I think that's all you need to know right now. I think we're ready, Hila. Let's get started.
Let's get started. Let's open up to Norway. Let's open up to Tix. I love your outfit. Hello, Tix. How are you feeling? Yes, you do need a microphone.
Got this one there.
You just keep
guys.
Let's give a big round of applause for Tix. How you feeling?
Well, I've been crying for like 10 minutes now, so I'm feeling good. I got a touch up with makeup just recently.
You look great.
Thank you.
So we have time for a question from the national press. So time for a question from the journalist from Norway.
Norway?
Yes.
Are you guys here?
Norway, are you here?
Wow.
Hey,
I should sit down then, maybe.
Would you please stand up, sir, introduce yourself, and ask your question?
Did you guys have fun today?
Yes.
I had to finally, like, people meeting together. I had the best time. I'm sorry. Here we go.
Okay, hello, Tix.
Hello.
Hello, everyone. I'm Lars from Norway, from Dagbladet. And I'd like to ask you, Tix, congratulations on going through to the grand final, first of all.
Thank you.
And how are you now going to improve your performance for the grand final?
Well, there's still a lot more to be told when it comes to the story I'm trying to tell here in the Netherlands. Well, I feel like I made it. Eurovision is about diversity, acceptance, and finally coming together. And the fact that I get to perform my song one more time just means that I'll be able to reach out to even more people out there. To a lot of people that might really, really need it. And that's basically the only reason I'm here. I wasn't really planning on going to Eurovision, you guys. I was just gonna do this in Norway because I really wanted people to understand the message that I was trying to convey. I wanted people to just feel better. Because it's been a really miserable year for a lot of people. And I think it's really time to put mental health on the agenda. Are you crying too? So am I.
We are so happy that you are here and of course that you are a finalist. And now it's time for a question from the international press. If anybody has a question, please raise your hand so our assistant can come to you.
Come on, William, you got a question,
don't
you?
We have a
question. You've been asking questions all week.
We have a question over there for our assistant. Hi. Our assistant, a question over there with the lady.
How much time do I got?
Well, we don't have a lot of time, but it's your moment.
It's
your moment, so you can take as long as you want.
Hey!
That was a really short pause, but thank you.
And once again, it's Norway, so it's TV2 Norway.
Hello.
I just wondered which performance did you like the most, your or Azerbaijan's, because you were dancing quite a lot backstage to Azerbaijan's song.
Well, I can't remember anything of my own performance, and I haven't even seen it yet, so Azerbaijan.
But I really, well, I don't know if you've seen, but I've kind of been dancing tonight. I don't know if you can see on my face right now, but I'm kind of sweaty. It's like 50 degrees in here, Celsius.
In your coat?
I had the
tonight, you guys. And I know I... 3,500 people in the arena at the same time as I did.
It was so much fun.
And, of course, the people watching online. We have a question coming in online for you. This is Martin from the UK Bradley Stoke Radio. Congratulations on making it to the final.
Thank you.
When you took your glasses off in the interview in Norway, I think that was to show that Andreas was there and not Tix. Was you taking your glasses off this evening showing Andreas off on stage?
I can show you guys now.
There you are.
Sorry, what was the question again?
The question was it tonight showing the Andreas off on stage instead of Tix when you took off your glasses?
In a way, yeah. Sorry. I've talked to a lot of you guys recently, but I'll just say it again. Fallen Angel is a song about feeling inadequate, feeling out of place in this world, and it's a song about not knowing your own worth, and the message I'm trying to send here is that you can turn your biggest weakness into your greatest strength. I'm trying to inspire people out there, I'm trying to give people a sense of hope, and I feel like it was necessary to take him off on stage because otherwise, people would just see the show and they would wonder, like, who's this guy dressing up like an angel? Who does he think he is? What is he hiding? What's his weakness? And showing that weakness, the reason why I'm, like, in combat with these demons, showing that weakness is basically the most important part of the show, I think.
And I think
it's about embracing your weaknesses.
Yeah.
It's about embracing yourself.
And you did, and we are so happy that you did, because you're in the final, and it's time for the allocation draw, which I am going to need your help for it.
What does that mean?
Because you will get to see in which half you will perform this Saturday.
Hold on, wait, what?
Yes.
There are different halves?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Cool. Do I get to choose or do you?
You get to choose.
Wow.
But it's my hand in the bowl. Oh, wait a minute.
Okay.
But you get to say stop.
Can I come closer though?
You can come closer.
I can't see what you're doing.
You can come closer. Oh, no worries. We'll get that later.
We'll get.
Okay. You can say stop, okay? You can use that.
Right.
We'll have to rebuild this table after.
So,
that's
what
okay.
Is his name? Is my name in one of those?
No, this is... you get a number, so the first half or the second half. Are you ready?
One or two. Well, I bet if I didn't ask this question, somebody else probably would have done. So this is like, yeah, I'm the first one here.
You say so,
okay.
And then you can say if this one is the one that you want.
What happened to the audio here? What the... Second half! You guys are really quiet for being journalists. Come on, guys. Normally there's like flashes everywhere. Come on, guys! First or second half?
Second? Really? I would have chosen the first. Okay. Well, okay.
Just say stop whenever you're ready.
Yeah, I just really enjoy this music. I'm like so indecisive. You know, when I order food at McDonald's, I spend like 30
takes.
TikTok.
Tix?
TikTok. Question.
We're nervy.
Alright, okay. Oh, okay, whatever. Just pick one.
Do you want this one? You have to say yes or no.
Ah,
it's your choice.
I bet Tusa is gonna have like the same issue as I. Okay, I choose that one.
Yeah? Okay. There we go.
It's gonna be Destiny! Second half!
Woo! Second half, Tix.
Alright, so what do you guys think? Is that a good thing or a bad thing? Why is that a good thing?
It's an echo.
Myself,
yeah, it's an echo. We'll, artist, and whatever place you have, you will rock it. I'm sure of that.
Thank you.
Stix,
so
thank you so much for your time. It's time for a photograph moment, so you can head over to our press wall, and of course the photographers that know that they can head over to the press wall are invited to go over there. And I would like to have a big applause for Norway. And
thank you. I can't wait to meet the other artists. I'm sorry I couldn't be more useful to you guys, but
you are very useful.
Kind of like in a
you
moment,
know,
right?
You know, we love having you on stage. So
alright, see you later, guys.
Bye, Tix. I love that you never know what you're going to get with Tix. I love that. Thank you. So, in a few moments, we will be back with the delegation of Israel. And if you have any questions for the delegation of Israel, please send us your questions in the online press center. Coach will be right back for you. See you.
And let's continue with the next qualifier. A big applause. And let's open up to Israel. Let's open up to said the next country is Israel, and then what happens?
I didn't understand the word you said. I'm still I hear myself. I'm just shocked. I'm speechless. I'm so excited.
Oh, congratulations. Okay, let's start with a question from the Israeli press. We have a journalist is called Antonia. She's sitting over there. Please stand up, introduce yourself. Go ahead.
My name is Antonia. I'm from Khan TV, the Israeli Broadcasting Corporation. Eden Mazal Tov.
Oh! That's
so happy for you. My question is, you know, Israel is suffering from very bad days, but this night you brought some smiles to the Israeli audience. We are live now on Khan TV. What do you have to say to your family and friends and boyfriend that is watching you right now?
I love you. Thank you for the support. I love my country. I love everyone. And this is for you, Israel. Just thank you. Thank you for all the love. I get so much love for my country. And it's just thank you. This is for you, Israel.
Thank you very much. Let's continue with a question for someone from the international press. I see a gentleman, I think, yes, over there. Please stand up, ask your question.
Mazal Tov, Eden. Hi. Congratulations. And when your country, Israel, was announced, it seemed you were really, really emotional. So I would like to ask you if you fear the televote more than the jury vote or the opposite. What scared you the most? Thank you.
I fear them both. I don't think that I fear them. I really wanted to go to the finals, so I was like hiding underneath my flag, and I was like, "Don Shma Israel, Shma Israel, Shma Israel, please, please, let us go to the finals." I didn't think about the judges. I didn't think about anything. I just wanted this for my country so bad, and I'm blessed. I'm so grateful.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's continue with a question from one of our online viewers. We have a question from Haklan from Focus Eurovision of Turkey. Eden, how did you keep yourself calm during that whistle note?
Oh, I didn't.
Oh, you didn't?
I didn't. I think that my dancers saved me in that moment. Just looking at them and getting those vibes and energy, that's why I think that I succeeded doing the whistles calmly.
Okay, you did a great job. Thank you
very
much.
Thank you so much.
And now it's going to be really exciting because it's time for the allocation draw.
Woo!
Which half of the grand final Israel will perform? I'll point my finger and you say stop, and then I...
Can I go next to you and see...
Of course you can go. Come over here.
I
we keep the distance. Saturday in the first half. perfect. Okay, gentlemen and Ellen, you can go that way because now it's time to make some beautiful photos. Only pool A photographers. Go that way, please. Thank you very much and enjoy the party tonight. Okay, in a few minutes we will continue with Russia.
So it's time to continue with another qualifier. Let's give it up for the delegation of Russia. Let's give it up for Manisha. Hello, everybody. It's so good to have you back.
So happy to see you, girl.
I'm so happy to see you.
Your shoes are stunning.
Thank you. You are all are stunning. How do you feel?
Oh my god, again, I want to say this F word, but I'm not going to. Oh, fantastic. Fabulous. And actually, to be honest with you, it's an amazing feeling. It's an amazing feeling that right now we made this semifinals with a huge audience. You see that? In the middle of pandemic, we made it. So first of all, I want to say to all the organization, because, oh yes, music, music, come back. Woo. And yes, I'm happy that I'm in finals. Yeah.
We are so happy as well. I'm sure the press of your country is happy as well. We have time for a question from Russia. The colorful lady over there, if you would please stand up, please.
Hello.
Please introduce yourself.
Hi, everyone. My name is Alex. I'm from Russian media platform Super.
Yay, yay.
Hi, Manisha. Congratulations. We're supporting you. And my question is, what now? What do you want to say to all haters who don't believe in you, who don't believe in your song, and who wrote all of those negative comments in social media? Thank you.
Oh gosh, again we're paying attention to the haters. But actually I have to say one thing. These 2 months was a little bit exhausting because yes, we had lots of haters. I don't like this word, haters. Not lovers, is okay? Not lovers. So the main thing what hurts me so bad, it was okay, the xenophobia and things and etc. But the main thing that people said to me that I will never, never, never get to the final with this song in Russian language. 18 years ago, Tattoo was on the Eurovision stage and they sang their song in Russian language. So I am so proud now that I am Russian woman who's singing in Russian language, and now I want to say these words in my language, Russian language. Россия, я тебя очень люблю. Я вас очень сильно люблю. Я хочу сказать, чтобы мы больше пели на русском языке, потому что русский язык, он прекрасен. Он невероятный. Спасибо вам большое.
Can you give a little translation for us?
Oh yeah, what I said. I said that Russia, I love you, and please respect your language. And let's sing in Russian a lot of times, because Russian language is very melodic, and I'm proud that I'm singing in Russian language.
Ah, that's beautiful, Manisha, thank you. So we have time for a short international question, sir, if you would please be so kind to stand up and introduce yourself, and of course your question.
Hello, everyone. My name is Dima, Dmitry. I represent Russian TV channel Zvezda. My congratulations for you. I have one question. Do you have a plan how to win this Eurovision?
What do I have, sorry?
A plan? I have a plan.
Oh.
To win Eurovision.
Actually, there is only one plan. In music, in Eurovision, everywhere, and to be yourself. Tonight I was so myself, you know what I mean? I was laughing. We were so happy to be on that stage. We were like, that's happening, and we can do whatever we want to do. So yeah, at the final I will be a little bit crazier than right now, but I will be myself. That will help you to be successful no matter what, you know, place you will get. Just be yourself.
I love that. So we have a question coming in online from Europhile Australia. Your song is Russian Woman, but what is your message now to the women of Europe, Australia, and the world?
Girls, we're all the same. We have the same problems. We have the same love hearts. I believe in you, and I know that these horrible things, what happens in our world, will never separate us. Trust me, I'm doing it in my art, because it's the only one reason to do art, to be brave and to be honest. That's it.
That's beautiful. Thank you, Manisha. So now it is time for your allocation draw. I will be circling around here.
Okay.
And you can say stop whenever you're ready.
Okay, I'll go there.
Yeah, you can come here. Mind the distance, that's all.
Please God help me.
You can say stop, and if it's the one that you want. I'm doing it with you.
Stop.
This one. Yes? There we go. Russia will be performing in the first half. You can follow as well. Thank you. Thank you. And in a few moments, we will be returning with Coase and with the delegation of Azerbaijan.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our next qualifier for the grand final of the Eurovision Song Contest 2021. Give it up to Azerbaijan. Let's open up to Effendi. Effendi, I think I know the answer, but how are you?
Fine. Thank you.
Okay, let's start with a question from someone from your country. Is there a journalist from Azerbaijan who wants to ask a question to Effendi? Please raise your hands. Otherwise, maybe some people from the international press who want to ask something. Let me see the hands. Yes, I see JP sitting over there. Hello, stand up. Please, thank you very much.
Hello, Effendi, Team Azerbaijan, congratulations.
Hello, thank you so much.
In the first week, you showed us a flag that Eldar gave you when he won you at Eurovision 2011. Where was this flag tonight? And did it bring you the luck? Of course it did.
In the Mubarak, my Muslim daughter.
That is the same flag right now on her.
But where was it during the performance? Did you bring it to the green room?
Bu bayrak elbette ki bizim komandamızdaydı. Heyecan dolusuyla beni gözlüyordular.
The flag was with my team members. They were waiting for me.
Ama bunu da size söylemek isterim ki ben Eldar'la zengileştim sahneden önce. Video görüntüledi.
I called Eldar before my stage.
Ve bana çoklu çoklu uğurlar diledi. Ve dedi ki bu hayatın en güzel anıydı. Sen bunu bir daha belki yaşamayacaksan ona göre çok sana uğur arzu ederim.
He wished me good luck and said you will never leave this moment again. So leave it right now and good luck to you.
Ve en esası da ki sahneden, ifandan ve orada olan tamaşaçılardan, abu havadan lezzet almağı bacar.
Enjoy, he said me, enjoy the audience, the stage and everything you see right now.
Çok sağ ol, thank you.
Okay, great, thank you. We have a question from one of our online viewers, Effendi. This is from AGAE Azerbaijan. I want to ask, what new elements are you going to add to your final performance?
Maybe, I don't know. Olabilsin. Olabilsin hansısa benim jestikulatalarımda değişiklikler oldu.
There could be some differences in my final, but I won't tell you right now.
Ah, you have a surprise for us.
Biz yenilikleri severik.
We love differences, we love to add new things.
Okay, we're looking forward to that. Do we have a question from someone here in the room? Otherwise, it's time for the allocation draw. We're gonna find out in which half you will be performing next Saturday. This one? That one? That one? That one? Magical moments here on stage, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna take this one. Okay, let's see. Azerbaijan will perform in second half! Okay, family, take care. It's time for the photographers only. The pool A photographers can go that way. You can go that way. There are lots of people who want to make a photo of you. Thank you very much.
It's time to continue with the next qualifier. Let's hear it for Malta. Let's hear it for Destiny. Hey, what? All right. Destiny, how do you feel?
I feel fantastic. I'm so grateful to have made it this far, and now I'm performing in the finals. Oh my god! I feel so, so happy.
Thank you. Smile to everybody's faces. Now it's time for some questions. The first one is for the national press, so for the press of Malta. So if you are from the press of Malta, please raise your hand, or else we will continue with the international questions. There's already some international questions. Do we have international questions? Sir, if you would be so kind, please stand up. Well, the gentleman behind you, yes. If you would be so kind to introduce yourself and, of course, your question.
Leonardo Taddei, Reality Magazine from Italy. Congratulations, Destiny. You did a wonderful performance and you made it to the final. I don't know if you know it, but you've also raised in the odds. Now you're second right after Italy to win the contest. So do you really think this could be the first year of Malta to win the Eurovision Song Contest, and in case, what are your expectations? Thank you.
So obviously, I feel good, but you know what I have to say to that? I'm so happy to be here. I'm honored, actually. I'm thankful for all of you who voted to see me in the final. I feel amazing. It's like you can't describe it. It's a feeling. You just have to feel it. I spoke to my dancers previously and I told them I can't describe it to the press how I'm feeling right now. It's magical, it's so special, it's such a special moment. I feel thankful and grateful, and I just want to thank you all for voting, and I love you all so, so much. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we have room for one more international question, so if you would be so kind to stand up, introduce yourself.
Hey Destiny, congratulations.
Thank
you're talking on the podcast. Your song is about staying true to yourself and owning your voice. You've done that in the last week despite many people failing online trying to tell you what to do, what to wear. How does it feel now that you stay true to yourself and that made you go to that final?
Whew. Whew. You know what? To answer this question, I need to stand up.
Yes!
I need to stand up because my song, all about female empowerment. It's all about you beautiful women out there.
Yes.
Power.
Yes.
This is my life story, but you know what? It's about me, yeah, but it's not just about me. It's about me, it's about you, and it's about us. And I want to thank you all so, so much for believing in me and for loving the message of the song.
Yes.
I love you all.
Thank you. That's a beautiful message. And we are continuing to the questions that are coming in online. This one is, hi Destiny, Emu Kalea Bayliss from Malta. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Being an adult, Eurovision was always a big dream for you and of course a big wish for your grandfather. How does it feel having achieved this goal and being in the final?
Oh, this question always gets me emotional because I know how proud he is right now, because it was his dream, it was my dream and his dream. I mean, I've been working so hard for it and I'm finally living my dream with you guys who supported me and who believed in me, which makes it much more incredible. And obviously passing to the finals, I know he's like crying, he's shedding tears, but it's so great to like have passed to the finals and I'm making him proud. I can't describe it. Thank you, Amin. Thank you. It was an emotional question and I will cherish it. Thank you.
Thank you. So now it is time for your allocation draw. I'm gonna go around in the bowl and it's up to you to say stop and if it's the one that you want.
There, yeah.
Come closer.
From someone here in the room. Is there someone from Lithuania who wanted to ask a question?
Yeah, from our national.
Oh yes, hello, there you are. Is it possible to stand up? Yes, please. Yeah. Please wait for the microphone, then we can hear you. Yes. Oops.
Hello, I'm from Lithuania's national broadcast LRT, and I wanted to ask you, so what are your thoughts? Are you already thinking about the grand final show on Saturday?
Yeah, we're thinking about that, and first sleep. Yes, and we are ready for the final, because we know what we want to achieve there, and we are very extremely happy to be in the finals. I think all Lithuanian people are very happy because you know Lithuania had the chance to win last year. But it's true, yeah. But it was cancelled, so they are very looking forward to this year. I don't know what the end will be, but Lithuanians are very happy.
We'll see, life's unpredictable.
Yeah. Life's unpredictable,
absolutely. Yeah. Great, thank you. We have a question from our online viewer. It's from Taut Fidos from Eurodina. For over a year, events were happening without any audience. Did the fact that there were 3,500 people in Ahoy give you that extra boost?
Oh yes, absolutely. Yeah, I mean it was such a thrill. At first, when we did the rehearsals, it was in an empty arena,
yeah.
Right? And then first thing when we came in, you know, into the first show where the audience was in, you can feel it. Well, we wear headsets, right? But you can feel them through the microphones, everybody's, you know, just cheering.
Yeah, we could hear them yelling, they liked
yes,
the song.
Exactly, you know,
first I
thought the energy
it was recorded, really. I thought that. Yeah, then someone pushed the button and
yeah,
just...
Yeah. But then I... Oh, really? Oh, yeah. It's happening, yeah.
It was one big discotheque, I think.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, we have time for one more question from someone here in the room. Otherwise, we're gonna find out in which part of the final you have to perform. No questions anymore? Okay, then we will continue. I will pick a paper for you. If you say stop, then I...
Okay, just wiggle mingle.
Stop!
Okay, this is the best.
I think so. Okay, Lithuania will perform in second half. Okay guys, congratulations, have fun tonight.
Yeah,
yes.
Thank you.
Take care, stay safe, and go that way please. And the Pool A photographers can go that direction and make the photo you want to make. Thank you very much.
Hi everybody, welcome back. Still awake? Still alive and kicking? Well, before we start, because we have another delegation coming up, please let's hear it for our volunteers and our assistants of today, because they are running their ass off. Yes. To keep everything clean for the next qualifier. And of course, keep clapping because here is the next qualifier. Here is the delegation of Cyprus. Here is Elena Sagrinou. Oh, how are you feeling, Elena? Happy?
I can't believe I was screaming like crazy. I don't know what happens.
I just blacked out.
Yes, blacked
really?
Out. I was like blacked out. The girls come to me like, you know what happened, right? Yes.
Well, we are so happy to have you.
Best feeling ever.
I can imagine.
Like,
I can't even imagine. I can't imagine what's going through you. Congratulations.
Thank you. We won it so much.
And so we have time for a question from the delegation itself, from the press. Is there a question coming in from Cyprus here in the actual room before we continue with the international questions? Let's continue with the international questions. Sir, if you would be so kind to stand up, introduce yourself.
Hey, Elena. You previously told me that you really got emotional when I told you that you wanted to make people dance. And tonight I saw videos from the venue where you actually made people dance and enjoy themselves again. How was that feeling of making that happen?
The best feeling ever after COVID life, that we all feel that we're not so free. I just feel that it's the new beginning for all of us. Like, we're gonna start from the beginning and feel the freedom that we all want. So, woo! I feel that we are in the right place.
Thank you. So we have a question coming in online. This one is, hi Elena, congrats. It's Haftab from Focus Eurovision of Turkey. We saw that since rehearsals, you were so consistent with your performance. Did you feel nervous before you got on stage tonight?
You know, when I'm gonna get on stage, I really be in the best position of my mind to feel the best feeling, and when I'm feeling it, I just can't get off the stage. And it happens today, really.
And I'm so happy you felt it, because I'm so happy that you are here, yes!
Yeah.
And now it is time for your allocation draw. And it is up to you to let me know when to stop.
Yes,
so I'm going to go around.
All right.
And you can say stop, and if it's the one that you want.
Okay. So, yes,
stop. Stop?
Yes.
This one?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. So Cyprus will be performing in the first half. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, everyone, three more countries to go. Ukraine, Belgium. But first, let's open up to Sweden. Tissa, congratulations. Okay. Let's go back to that moment. You heard the name of your country, Sweden. And then, what happened?
We went crazy. This, for you guys who doesn't know how it felt being there, because that was my first time, it was torture waiting.
Really?
You know, oh god, it was torture.
Okay, let's continue with a question from the Swedish press. I see you sitting over there. Stand up, please. Hi.
Tobias from Swedish newspaper Aftonbladet. Among a lot of songs with very strong messages, it can be quite tough to stand out. So what is the message that you hope that the European audience got from you tonight? And also, I want to know how it feels to actually have taken Sweden to the finals again, the 10th time in a row.
Yes! We did it! We did it! Song, I was blown away by how you can unite people in one song, and this song is the one. I mean, I'm here to say that my voice counts, your voice counts, all our voices count, and we showed that tonight, and it's so beautiful, and I'm so happy Europe liked it and sent us to the finals, and I'm so glad that Sweden are in the finals once more. I didn't betray them.
Get it! Great. Okay. More questions from the people who are here in the room. Question from Tusa. Yes, JP, over there, I guess.
Hello, Tusa. It's JP from Radio International. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Right, again, you nailed it. But you sing the song Voices. And I know that you had some trouble with your voice before coming to the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yeah.
How thrilling or nerve-wracking was it for you that your voice would get back on scratch for the contest?
Oh, it's been a hard, it was a tough period right before, like 1 month before this, where I was like, can I even sing tomorrow? Will I be able to do Eurovision? So to stand here and to prove that I can do it and that we can do it with one voice, I feel so proud and so happy. I just feel happiness and joy. And I'm so glad that my voice is back and it's functional. Only joy. I only feel joy.
Great. Okay. We have one more question from one of our online viewers. It's from Sergio Lopez from Yo Tele in Spain. Hello. Thank you for sending in your question. Who do you dedicate tonight's classification to?
Oh my God, I dedicate it to everybody that feels or have felt lonely or feels or have felt that their voice hasn't been counted or hasn't been heard. Because if a small child from a small country in a small place can get this far, anybody can. And I think that because we all sometimes feel alone, and feel lonely, that means we're not alone, because we all been there. We have each other, and we all have emotions, and we all know how that feels. That means we're in it together. So I dedicate it to us lonely souls out here in the world that aren't lonely at all.
Wow. Okay, Tusa, now it's gonna be really exciting, because we're gonna find out in which half Sweden will perform next Saturday. You can say stop, and then I pick one of these.
Okay, and if I don't say stop, will we win?
And then I will keep this turning all night long.
Stop.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Sweden will perform in second half. Okay, I wish you all the best, and good luck the next day. You can go that way, because now there's the opportunity for the Pool A photographers to make a photo. Enjoy it, eh?
Thank you so much!
Bye!
And we are back. Let's hear it for our next qualifier. Let's hear it for the delegation of Belgium, and let's hear it for Hoover Phonic.
Thank you very much.
How was it?
It was nerve-wracking.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was nerve-wracking.
What did it feel like when hearing your name?
It felt like, it just felt great. It was a lot of pressure on our shoulders last week. And it's just like, you know, it's a relief. Because, you know, like, it's not because you're a band that's already touring for 25 years and that you gotta go through, you know, and there's nothing
even harder.
So it was really like, we can go back to our country now. without being killed or decapitated, you know.
Well, not just yet. We still have Saturday to go, so we are very happy to have you here. So now it's time for a question for the press, sir, if you would be so kind to stand up. Thank you. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, Alex, Jacques, and Raymond. I'm Jens from RTV Europe. Congratulations.
congratulations, and thank you for showing all the doubters that Eurovision is definitely not the wrong place for Belgium or Europhonics. So congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Yes. You received many video messages from Belgian and Dutch celebrities like Clouseau, Sandra Kim, even Bluff, and it made you very emotional, clearly. But which video message made you or touched you the most?
Oh, that's a good question. It's like oh, Siri doesn't understand. Okay, I'm sorry, Siri, but I'm in the middle of an interview here, so shut up, please. I have to say all of them because they're all dear friends, you know. Koen Wouters, Bart Peters, of course, I know them from The Voice, but you know, like
Sandra Kim.
Yeah, that's Sandra Kim.
Pascal Fantastis.
We had so many. I got a personal message right after we won from Tom Dice, you know, who was sixth in the competition. I got a personal message from Dan Laxman, who participated in the 80s with Eurovision, you know, like, so all these people that participated, you got a message from Barbara Dex, you know, like, it's just great to see that the whole of Belgium is, like, you know, supporting us, except one guy from national television, you know, like, he's not really into us, but hey, all the rest, they're just very supportive, so thank you very much for supporting us, you know, even after 25 years, sometimes people think, like, oh, they're okay, but it's just nice if you feel like, you know, the warmth. And so people like Koen Wouters, who actually also participated back in, I think, 89, when he says, like, enjoy, it's a great experience, then, well, we can also say that to all bands in Belgium, don't hesitate, go for it.
Do it.
It's just fun, you know, it's like, it's a great experience, you should do it.
Thank you. Thank you for that question. We have time for another question, sir, if you would be so kind to stand up, our assistant will make her way to you, if you would be so kind to introduce yourself, of course.
Good evening, Gianni from VRT. I did see a lot of emotions and relief when you were announced. How would you call your qualification? A victory for music?
Victory of music for music. It's just amazing. Just, you know, like when I got off stage, you know, like the first reaction I had was like, I'm speechless.
Yeah, and there's also, there's a lot of great acts. When we got on in the green room, there's a different impact as well from watching from the screen. So we were quite impressed. So.
And there's one thing I can say, you know, like being in the green room, it's not flattering photos, you know, you see of yourself.
Totally.
You know, like, it's like photos we've seen, it was like, oh, is that me? It's like, so no, but it's a victory. It's a victory of Hoover Phonic. It's a victory of Belgium. It's like, you know, it's a victory of
believers. It's a victory of believers. You know?
Yeah.
That's what it is.
A victory. We have question time for one more question over there. If you would be so kind to stand up, and our assistant is going to make her way to you.
Hi, Archie Fantôme from Belgium National Television. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You. Heike, at the end of your performance, I saw that big smile. Did you feel at that moment we're going through?
No, I just felt the joy of being in front of a crowd and being here in this place and being part of the whole thing. It's so much fun. It's been so much fun, and I felt like relief that I've gotten through the whole song. To be honest, we're never sure. So no, I was just happy that we got through with it.
Yeah, we're all happy that, like, 3,500 people in a room, it's like,
yeah,
been a while, you know, it's like...
How long has that been? Yeah.
We were in the green room and said, like, how long ago did we celebrate a party with so many people, you know? How long ago is that, you know? It's maybe only a year, but in a lifetime it's nothing, but for us it's like, it's a long time that we had to stay home, so this is just fantastic.
Thank you. So we have time for a short question online. This one is to Heike. How does it feel to be back again with the band?
I'm just happy. I cannot say much more, but I'm just sincerely, truly happy. It's all been so amazing so far.
Thank you. So now it's time for the allocation draw to see in which half we will be seeing you this Saturday. So I'm just going to point around and it's up to you to say stop. And if it's the one that you want,
stop.
This one?
Yeah, okay.
The hammer. There we go. So Belgium will be performing in the first half.
All right.
So we will be seeing you Saturday. So let's give it up for Overphonic. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now it's time for your press moment.
One more country to go. Let's open up to Ukraine. Hello. Good evening and concrete. Of course.
Thank you very much.
Flag. Yes. Let's go back to the moment. You were sitting there. And I think it was Jan or Chantal, they called Ukraine, the last one. And then what happened?
You know, it's quite difficult to express our emotions right now because we cannot scream anymore.
Yes. Save your voices, eh?
But we can dance.
Of course.
Music.
But I think you are really happy. You look really happy.
Very, very, very happy. Look at me. I'm happy. Thank you very much.
Okay, let's continue with some questions from the people here in the room. Are there some people from Ukraine? Yes, of course. The lady in
Red.
Yes,
my name is Alina Buhayeva. I'm from Ukrainian Public Broadcasting Company. So congratulations, and my question is, what do you think, why did people left you like an icing on the cake? And what did you feel and think in last minutes when 9 countries have been named? And guys, what's next? What next plan?
Чому люди вирішили вас залишити як вишенькою на торті? Що ви відчували і про що думали в останні хвилини, коли назвали 9 країн, і ви чекали ж, напевно. І що буде далі? Що наступне? Які плани?
Is it possible for you to answer in English, please?
Я можу спочатку українською.
Maybe she'll answer in Ukrainian and then I'll translate it.
Yes, perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Ну, якщо чесно, я вболівала за Австралію, і мені дуже хотілося, щоб вона потрапила до фіналу. Тому я дуже сподівалася, що якщо не ми, то Австралія. Але так сталося, що пройшли ми, і ми дуже щасливі.
Okay, so Katerina says that actually she voted for Australia, and she was thinking if it won't be us, then it should be Australia. Yeah, but still, we're in final, and she's very happy, and we are all very happy about it.
Great. Okay, there's another question from the gentleman over there. Please stand up.
Привет. Hi, good evening, welcome. And my name is Simon. I'm from Poland, writing this letter. Ladies and gentlemen, Ukraine becomes the only country in the Eurovision Song Contest which always qualifies to the final. Congratulations. And my question is, what makes your music and your songs in the Eurovision Song Contest so special?
Так. I should translate that. Кожного разу Україна виходила в фінал, що робить нашу країну такою особливою?
Ну, ми не боїмося бути собою, ми не боїмося показати свою країну, додавати до музики трошки свого колориту. Також ми дуже віддані такій справі, як Євробачення. Ми дуже серйозно ставимося до цього конкурсу і завжди кожен учасник, який був представлений до України, мав дуже серйозну підготовку до конкурсу.
Sorry, I couldn't remember everything, but I did my best. First of all, we just try to be, for our band, and I think for every contestant from Ukraine, we and they just try to be ourselves. Just performing and making music. Що там ще було? Yeah, and actually Eurovision is a very important event in Ukraine. I think that every contestant, every Ukraine's entry at Eurovision is preparing like very hard. So I think that's our thing.
Okay, we have time for one more last question from one of our online viewers, and the question is, how does it feel to qualify with a song completely sang in Ukrainian language?
Як це буде?
Все випадок перекладаємо все.
Так, звичайно. Як це буде? Як відчуття відчувається виходити в фінал з піснею повністю на українською мовою?
Ми відчуваємо величезну гордість, адже з самого початку, коли ми ще прийшли на нацвідбір український, ми хотіли співати українською мовою, і у нас була мета вперше на Євробаченні заспівати пісню повністю українською мовою, до того ж побудовану на українському фольклорі. Ми цієї мети досягли і потрапили в фінал. Для нас це дуже важлива подія.
So, since we have performed and participated at our national selection in Ukraine, so our goal was to show our Ukrainian music, Ukrainian folk music at the core of our band's music. And here in Eurovision, at Eurovision, I think that it's very important for us to show our heritage to the whole world. And okay, we are very honored to represent Ukraine.
Great. Thank you very much. Okay, and now it's time for the allocation draw. In which half of the grand final next Saturday will Ukraine perform? I will take one of these, how do you say it? How do you call this in English? Rolls? Yeah, there are rolls, I think. I call them rolls. When you say stop, I pick a roll. And then we're gonna find out in which half you will perform.
Stop.
This one? Ukraine will perform in second half. Okay, are you happy with that?
Thank you.
Great. Okay, now.